want to have a look now at calibrating this end jet. We'll be looking at our speed, our flow rate, and our width, how far it's throwing. Now, when we set this rig up to go and do some fence line spraying, we have 50 centimeter spacings here. We have to adjust our flow rate on this width to match what's happening with this rail. At 50 centimeter spacings and an 03 nozzle here, if we were doing 3 bar and 12 Ks, that would be 120 litres of water to the hectare. So what I want to do in this exercise is I want to actually set this up to do 120 litres of water to the hectare. Now our speed's going to be our 12 kilometres an hour. Our pressure will be our 3 bar. The only variable we're going to have to play with here is our width. So we'll have to adjust how far we're throwing this to ensure our 120 litres here is effectively the same as here. And this is a trap for people with their boom sprays. When you put one of these on, you can find your dilution rate isn't actually going into the fence line as you think. Really pays to check in, look at that width, how far you're throwing it, collect the flow, and do the calculations for litres per hectare. Some of the tools we're going to need for the job is we're going to need our measurement so we can get our width figure, some markers just to test, lay them out on the ground. We've already done our pressure test and we know that the pressure here and here is the same. We have our nozzle chart to refer to see how far or what our width is going to be. Little tip for you when you're driving and doing a fence line sprayer, rather than relying on the speedo, is just get the Navman or your TomTom and put it in the vehicle and you'll get a very constant speed. So we're talking, this is a manual system, so it's important that we do maintain a good constant speed. So we're happy with pressure. We now need to go through and we'll measure the flow rate with it. What I'll do there, I just use a handy 5 litre container that's been washed out and I can hold it over the nozzle because this is a fairly high flow nozzle. We need a container that's going to can carry a fair bit. Then we can weigh that and we'll have our litres per minute. Rightio, we're ready to measure our output, our flow rate from our end jet. Got my safety glasses on. I've already teared a container and recorded the tear result. Timekeeper's in position, ready to start up, and we'll okay, so we've got our 30 second grab of water there. We've done a quick calculation, and including the container, we're looking for 2.65 to see if our flow rate's right for that 3 bar test. We've actually got our weight here of 2.65, which is equating to 2.65 litres. So we've got our flow rate, we're happy with that as per the chart. We come back across to our nozzle and we've looked at our chart at that pressure and a 90 centimetre height. To achieve 120 litres per hectare, we have to have this nozzle throwing at that flow rate, 1.9 metres. That'll ensure that we've got 120 litres here, which is going to match our 03 nozzle at 3 bar and 12 Ks, which is 120 litres there. So the dilution rate's going to be the same on the back of the vehicle as it is throwing out into the fence line. So we're going to start it up, see what our wetted width is, and make the adjustment back down to 1.9 metres if we have to. Okay, so we've measured out our 1.9 metres here. We can see that we're actually overshooting the mark by quite a way, so we do need to make a quick adjustment just to bring that end jet back into that 1.9 metres. So we'll just get our shifter, get onto the jet. And we're probably a lot better just there with that setup. Okay, now we've got it all set up, let's go and give it a run and see what it looks like.